Hey man, did you get that intro video I sent you? I exported it all good and everything.
Oh yeah, man, I got the intro video. It's a little rough.
Oh, it doesn't look good?
Well, I mean, it kind of looks like it was exported by a potato.
Yeah, what resolution is this even in? Like, did you follow any of the settings that I posted from Instagram earlier?
Well, I exported it at 8K. Because I figured, like, double 4K, right?
Okay, so what I'll do is I'll go download the guide in the notes and I'll watch this video so I don't do that again. I'm really sorry.
Okay, well, just make sure you go do that.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
No, I'm sorry.
It's okay, stop.
It's okay.
No,
seriously. I'm sorry.
It's okay. Really okay.
I really am sorry.
People make mistakes. No, don't go. Don't go.
Hey, how's it going? I'm Cody J, and if you're new to the channel, this is my dog Mochi. She freaks out every time I talk, and I'm a filmmaker and a designer over at Revival Mode and a videographer over at Swoon Creative Collective. So if you can read the title and saw the intro, you know that we're going to talk about export settings today. So let's get right into Premiere so I can show you how to export stuff and make it look really good. So this is like my fourth time trying to do this. My computer keeps freezing. But anyway, we are now in Premiere, and we have our edit pretty much done. And I'm assuming you already know kind of how to use Premiere or any editor if you're watching this video, but if not, let me know down in the comments if you want like a beginner's video on Premiere. I'm planning on doing one anyway, but I'd love to hear from you or any other videos for that matter. So anyway, we have our edit done and we're gonna set our in and out points, which is just like 15 seconds, which is how long stories are on Instagram. When you have your footage imported and you bring it onto the timeline, pretty much Premiere is going to tell you the best settings, right? It's going to pick it, frame size, all that stuff. So all you're going to do is you're going to change your sequence settings, and you're just going to make it 1080 by 1920, which is vertical, and it's 9:16 aspect ratio. Whatever frame rate you want, I'm always 23976 and just conform everything to that. So we have that, and then I usually turn on maximum render and depth, but right now I'm going to turn them off. That's just for when you're editing so you can see stuff. You won't see like banding in your footage and all that. So I don't know what's up with this, but my TV keeps turning on and off. All right, so now we have all that set. So let's go to our export dialog box. So now that we have our export dialog box open, we will go to our format and we're gonna switch it to HEVC, which is H.265, which is just a heavier compression compared to H.264, but actually the quality is much better. And actually H.266 is coming soon. So they do have these presets here. I use the match source high bit rate when I've already set the sequence settings, but if I need to change it, you can use 4K UHD, 8K UHD, HD 1080p. All of these are great just for, you know, like uploading to Facebook. Don't do 8K to Facebook, do 4K or 1080p. Those are both gonna look great. And even 720p if you're putting like, you know, 4K footage onto it, that's fine too. So just use these presets for your different requirements. And then for this one, we're just gonna keep it at match source high bitrate. And we'll scroll down a little bit and we have, you know, make sure these settings are correct and they haven't changed. We're gonna make sure we tick this box right here, which is render at maximum depth. That's just making sure you're rendering it at the most possible bit depth that is available. And Premiere is making sure that it's extra good. All right, cool. So now we go down here. This is all should be set from your own settings. All right, nothing else to see here. And now we get to our bitrate settings. I noticed that if I just leave it alone, it seems pretty good. We have our VBR one pass at 7 megabits per second. File ends up being about 13 megabytes. And compared to H.264, it's actually 6 megabytes less. So what's happening is you are taking the file and you're making it smaller and you're even sending it to Instagram and they're going, oh wow, or TikTok or whatever. And they're saying, this file is already small. We don't really need to compress it any further. So they don't. And then guess what happens? Your footage looks great and there's no heavy compression that's happening after the fact. So that's a great file size too. Save tons of room on your hard drives. Don't end up with like 55 terabytes like we have because we shoot everything in ProRes. okay, so now this is all set. We are good. We're just gonna hit export. And it's pretty quick now that there's hardware acceleration in Premiere. So that's it, really. I mean, those are your settings. And I don't think there's really anything else we need to go over, but I will make another one of these for Facebook And I will make one for YouTube as well. I think Facebook and YouTube will probably end up being the same. But, you know, this one's for TikTok and Instagram. And all of those settings will work as stories, reels, posts, everything like that. So if you want to download the guide, the size guide to social media platforms for video, I have that down in the notes below. So make sure to download that. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And like this video if you enjoyed it. And leave a comment down below. Let me know kind of where you're at with all this, if it works for you, if it doesn't. This is what I found works the best for me. And I definitely want to hear from all of you guys about what you look for in the channel going forward, or what videos you want to see. Maybe there's something I do that you're like, how the heck does he do that? So I definitely want to hear from you. Just leave a comment, and it does help the channel get seen by more people. So I think that's it, but I will see you guys in the next video, and thank you so much. Again, I'm Cody J, and take care of yourselves.
Okay, well, I guess I'll go download the comments. Ha ha.